Cobalt Blue is Joel Crane. Joel, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew.
Good to see you, Joel. You've had this this market update out this week. The underground development, that's kicked off here. Give us a bit of an update as far as the demonstration plant. Where are we?
Sure. Well, yeah, the update we published yesterday is really just on the status of the development of the demonstration plant. So on the ground, we've excavated and graded the site where we're establishing a box cut that's cutting directly into the resource. Last Friday, we had the first blast and the major earthworks have commenced over the past week. So the next step of this installation is to put in a decline portal, which will extend about 80 meters and intersect with the ore body approximately 40 meters below the surface. And then once that's complete, we'll mine about 3,500 to 4,000 tons of ore over a period of about 20 weeks. This is over May, June, July. And really the demonstration plant is comprised of two activities. First, we'll crush, mill, and treat the ore to produce a cobalt concentrate right there on site. And then we truck it back to our processing plant, 23K up the road to Broken Hill for extraction and recovery of the cobalt as either MHP, the mixed hydroxide product, or cobalt sulfate.
And of course, Joel, this follows on from the pilot plant run, which you undertook last year.
That's right. We spent a solid amount of time last year doing the same type of thing, but on a much smaller scale. So we're able to now upscale this and increasing the throughput of the leach plant from about 40 kilograms per hour to about 125. And importantly, like I said, we're building this concentrate circuit on site as opposed to in town where it was last year. And then once we've upscaled this, we're then able to provide high quality production scale samples for our commercial partners around the world. And then importantly, of course, provide operating proof for project equity and debt funding markets.
Clearly an important step here, Joel. Just while this is taking place, what are we seeing at the moment within the cobalt space?
Well, cobalt prices, much like most commodities around the world, are seeing some pretty strong upward pressure. We're up about 15% since the beginning of the year to $39 per pound. That's about 60% up year on year. There's a couple of reasons that's occurring. On the supply side, there's a bit of tension, particularly around Chinese ports. We obviously have seen not only the supply chain difficulties, but some fresh COVID-related lockdowns in China. Given that's where 70% of the world's cobalt is refined, you're going to see some troubles getting that material out as quickly as some of the market participants would like. Like many other commodities, cobalt's wrapped up in the issues that's happening in Russia and Ukraine. About 1 to 2% of the world's cobalt comes from Russia. So there is some concern on the availability of that material, you know, in the longer term. On the demand side, of course, it's all about the EV story. EV sales continue to be quite strong. And there's also a continuing and increasing demand for ethically sourced battery raw materials, and cobalt certainly not immune from that. So there's a bit of tension in the market around trying to access those sort of tons, and that's just putting a lot of pressure in the market. So until these supply and demand factors relax, I don't anticipate any major downfall in the cobalt price in the near term.
Good to see you this morning. Joel, thanks very much.
Thank you, Andrew.